alley setback.
Every time Larry Merchant gets in there, he has nothing but negative things to say about the fighters. And he's attacking Floyd. Floyd just got headbutted in the face. You know, in this huge fight that he was fighting. It wasn't like Floyd was being dirty or anything. The dirtiest thing you can do in a boxing match is headbutt somebody in the face.
Or a low blow.
Yeah. Well, it's, headbutts are worse. You cut him. I mean, you could break his nose. There's so many things you can do. Listen, it's not fun getting hit in the nuts, but it's nowhere near comparable of being headbutted in the face. And I went back and watched it. And I'll do the same thing with the Manny Pacquiao fight that night.
Thank you.
So, cool. So you're going to watch the Manny Pacquiao fight also that same day?
What's that?
You're going to watch the Manny Pacquiao fight?
Oh, yeah, I'm going to watch. I'm a Pacquiao fan. I'm a huge Pacquiao fan.
Who do you think wins between Floyd Mayweather and Manny Pacquiao?
I think me and Floyd both know who wins that fight. That's why Floyd's not taking it.
I'm here at the 29th Annual Sports Spectacular. It's a huge event with sports stars. They raise money to fight diabetes. We caught up with some of the stars on the red carpet. Check it out. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You've seen him in a Subway commercials. Mike Lee's pro boxer.
I did see him in the Subway.
You have an NFL?
I just met him here for the first time.
NFL star over here with us?
How you doing? Dana, nice to meet you.
What's it like being honored tonight, Dana?
Well, for the last 13 years, I've been fighting for, the athletes of this sport to be recognized like all other athletes, and obviously for the UFC to be recognized as the high caliber sport it is, and to be here tonight amongst all these other athletes, it's a big deal for us.
You worked so hard. When you started, you never imagined you'd be on the red carpet in Hollywood with Robert Ori and Steve Nash and Gonzalez and Mike Lee.
Right.
What's it like?
Well, obviously, when we started this thing, this is the day you look forward to. You work hard every day to strive to get the company to this level, and more importantly, to get the athletes recognized. So it's a big deal.
Right before you stepped in there, we were talking about Mayweather Maidana. Before the fight, you said mismatch, if I'm not mistaken.
Right.
But it was a very close fight.
It was a bet. And before the fight, I don't know if I said mismatch. What I said was, there's other fights that I'd like to see Floyd fighting in. But Floyd is one of these guys, love him or hate him, you got to respect the fact that at his age, what he's still able to do is very impressive. Same thing with I was just talking about him.
Bernard Hopkins?
No, last night.
Marquez.
Marquez. Yeah.
I mean, Marquez, 40 years old,
and he's a stud, man. 40 years old, the guy's still a stud. What's more impressive about him is the shots he takes, it looks like he's out of it, and then he comes back stronger. I love the guy.
It's impressive.
What do you think of Mayweather Maidana?
I think Floyd's the best boxer in the world. I think he's got incredible feet, and he knows how to speed up and slow down the pace of the fight. When you're fighting, it's all about rhythm, and Floyd knows how to change the rhythm at the drop of a hat. So, like Dana said, I'd love to see him fight some other guys, too.
Dana has his own pound-for-pound superstar, John Jones, stepping in the ring in a rematch. What is he going to do differently this time versus the first time?
Well, I would think that he's going to try not to get hit as much as he got hit last time. And that was the sickest light heavyweight fight in the history of the UFC. And I'm looking forward to it. I think the fans are looking forward to it too.
Last thing I gotta ask you, Dana. You said that Ronda Rousey beats Floyd. I didn't think so. A lot of trainers and fighters, Ann Wolf, if you saw the interview with her, do you really believe she beats Floyd?
Yeah. Now let's put that in context. In a boxing match, Floyd beats her all day long.
Okay.
In a street fight or in the octagon, she hurts him bad.
I mean,
she'd hurt him bad too. I'll throw him right in. She'd hurt him bad too. She'll take this whole line out right here. Okay, the whole line. She'll take them all out.
I think in a lot of ways it's almost two different sports.
That's exactly right.
People always want to compare it like that, but there's things that I can never do in an octagon, and there's also stand-up techniques that fighters, that boxers
right.
have. So, you just have to have mutual respect for both sports.
She's an Olympic medalist in judo. She's an Olympic medalist. Listen, this is a true story. She got into a street fight with two huge guys in a movie theater. She hurt them both so bad they went to the police department and filed charges against her when they're the ones that started the fight with her.
Wow. How long ago was
legit,
that?
Legit, that's real. That was before she started fighting. That was when she was doing judo alone. Believe me. I wouldn't just say it.
I'm not just throwing it
out there to say it. She trained her whole life with men, big men. There weren't a lot of women in American judo. She trained with men her whole life.
So, Dana, last thing, what's your next big UFC event you want to tell everybody about?
This weekend. This next Saturday, Barao versus Dillashaw, Dan Henderson versus Cormier, and Ellenberger versus Robbie Lawler. Live on. on pay-per-view.
There you have it. The one and only Dana White. Congratulations. This is big for the UFC.
Thank you.
Big
I appreciate
for you.
It. Okay.
So there you have it. From the Sports Spectacular, where they're raising money to help Cedars-Sinai fight diabetes. I'm Ali Sekpak reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekpak.